whatever we set our mind to. That is the story of our history. Whether it's the pursuit of prosperity for our people, or the struggle for equality for all our citizens, our commitment to stand up for our values abroad, and our sacrifices to make the world a safer place. Let us remember that we can do these things not just because of wealth or power, but because of who we are. One nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. May God bless you. And may God bless the United States of America.
That was President Obama around 11:15, 11:30 tonight in the East Room of the White House, declaring that Osama bin Laden was dead, a historic speech that will clearly be remembered for generations, a speech that many Americans didn't think would ever come. Joining me now is our political anchor, Errol Lewis, and our Pat Kiernan is here. He wasn't due here for another 3 hours, but as you know now, no New Yorker, and I don't think any American can sleep after getting this news, Pat. You were on the air live when that first tower was hit.
And for the same reasons you and Errol have been discussing, the emotional connection of a New Yorker to this news is one that you can't detach yourself from as a journalist. There is just a...
as a state. And the Marlboro Bicycle kicked off Sunday morning, part of the 42-mile ride. It was over the 3rd Avenue Bridge through Mott Haven and over the Madison Avenue Bridge. Over 30,000 cyclists participated in the event. Thieves on the trains are after your high-tech gadgets. The next cop is sentenced for a beating caught on video and another video of a bomb scare. Here's Kevin McCabe with your Weekly Chronicle.
The NYPD says thieves are snatching smartphones in subways. Robberies jumped 18% in March, and authorities believe that increase is largely due to smartphones and tablets like the iPad. Authorities say many of the thefts occur during rush hour on the 4, 5, and 6 trains. You should avoid riding near the door, spot where thieves can snatch and go. Always be aware of your surroundings, keep your cell phone out of sight and in a secure area, and use your phone security lock. Former Bronx police officer caught on tape beating a handcuffed suspect pleads guilty to misdemeanor assault charges. Here is video of the incident. Happened back in January 2010. Prosecutors say 30-year-old former officer John Cicero now admits he punched the victim, Jonathan Baez, in the head numerous times before slamming the victim's head into the pavement during the
size of plane that you think of in the Corey Lytle incident or something like that, and then that's what you're thinking of, and then we went through the next couple of hours just with one event after another, and it wasn't long, as you know, before Osama bin Laden's name.